everyone and welcome to year 7 chapter 4 of Hogwarts Mystery. I have no ideas for a quirky intro today. It's not that I'm particularly sleepy, I just really have no ideas. Find out what Dumbledore has to say. To be honest, at this point, does anybody actually care what Dumbledore has to say? At least that we know that at this point it's not about stop looking for cursed wands, that stuff is over. So, I know it's about the trips outside of Hogwarts. According to the data mine, we're supposed to go to the ministry in chapter 5. So, I don't know what this is. Is this prepping to go? Because I haven't won the full marks yet. The full marks are still going. And I want that dress. I want that dress as Sarahi's casuals. The spring peacoat is very pretty. I think that would really work well as Sarahi's casuals. Yep. Okay, for the love of God, seriously, Jam City, for the last time, please give Barnaby casuals. Talbot and Andre too, by the way. They all deserve casuals. Believe me, if Jam City doesn't give Barnaby casuals, I will. You asked to see us, Professor Dumbledore? We haven't messed up this year, so you cannot do anything this time. Uh-huh. Indeed, are all of you here? We're standing in front of you, sir. Well, there's me, Tonks, Liz, Charlie, Ben, Sarahi. The portrait of Phineas Nigel is Black, the portrait of Armando Dippet, Fox, Barnaby, the ultimate troll, and I love him. You could have just said yes, Barnaby. No, that was good. This is the ultimate troll. This is how we should talk to Dumbledore on a daily basis. Confuse the hell out of him. I had to double check. Yes, thank you. Thank you for doing that. It can never hurt to double check. God damn it, he didn't troll him enough. But on to why I gathered you six here today. Six. As all of you know, at the beginning of the year, I mentioned a very special arrangement. Yes, that we get to go outside of school and everything. Is this about going off school grounds to think about future careers, Professor? I can hardly wait to hear what we might be assigned. If you don't assign me Magic Zoology, I will actually lose faith in humanity. Indeed, it is Miss Silvers, but you'll have to listen carefully to the details. Okay. Good thing I finished studying the Migratory Patterns of Dirikols. Okay, yeah, that's about Magic Zoology. I've chosen you six for your talents and interests. Okay. I better get Magic Zoology! The first place you'll visit is the Ministry of Magic. Yes, we got that much. Seems like we've been waiting for this news forever. No, you've only been waiting for it for a couple of weeks. I get the feeling the Romanian Dragon Sanctuary isn't one of the career options. Oh, Charlie, oh god, I'm sorry. I don't know what kinds of things we'll be doing. I want to see magic. I want to pick Magic Zoology. Please be magical law enforcement. I better get the Department of Regulation and Control of Magic Creatures. I swear to god. Otherwise, this trip will be a complete bust. I hope to get hold of baby Hippogriff or baby Ogre or... Yes, I want to do all that as well. Please take me with you. No, it is not just an excuse to spend time with Barnaby. It's that I legitimately also want to pick Magic Zoology. My back and foot really hurt today. It is like I'm having an allergic reaction to a party. And the thing is, I had fun at the party. I went to a party a couple of days ago. It was great. I had fun. But it's like my body is having an allergic reaction. It's kind of funny actually. Despite this being possible because of some close friends, remember that you are representing Hogwarts. Uh-huh. Everything you do at the Ministry of Magic will reflect on our school. Uh-huh. Any questions? Why does the music always stop in your office? And why is it always awkward silence? Yes, you said you chose this based on our talents and interests. Uh-huh. Indeed, you six are excellent candidates for the ministry. Just us six? Okay. Miss Tongs for a dependability... I'm sorry. Dependability. Uh-huh. Mr. Lee for his loyalty. Yes, that I agree. Miss Tuttle for her knowledge. Mr. Weasley for his bravery. Okay. Mr. Copper for his steadfastness. And finally, Miss Silvers. Some have called you stubborn, some lucky, and some ambitious. Oh my god. Which one of these qualities do you possess? I think I'm just lucky, to be honest. I suppose I'm just lucky, Professor Dumbledore. I'm pretty sure I've got out of all my situations with sheer luck and the fact that MC has plot armor. what's the saying? Fortune favors the bold? I don't know. Uh-huh. You've been chosen to go for these qualities, but also for your heroic efforts in sealing the cursed wand. That was mostly me and Rowan. And actually Bill. Barnaby was only there once. Liz didn't go with us a single time. Not that I didn't wish for them not to go. Jam City won't let us take anyone. Barnaby was there for the last fall, so yeah. Okay, never mind. I'm not questioning this anymore. Which is why, first and foremost, you will be starting the Department of Magical Law Enforcement. Okay, good for Tongs. But after that, I get to go to the Department of Regulation and Control of Magical Creatures. Say that name, that's a very long name. It's getting tiring to say it. You really think they'll put us on aura training, Tongs? That soon will be entirely up to the ministry. You're really just leaving children up to the government, aren't you? Now, I trust you all to balance your time at the ministry with your studies. Do not let me down. I have never cared about you, sir. Honestly. Of course, President Dumbledore, I don't really care. Excellent. You'll pick up the necessary credentials to explore the ministry upon arrival. Okay. There's always some business you must attend to. Where is there not business for you to attend to? Now, if you'll excuse me, there's some business I must attend to. Yeah, whatever. Magical creatures! I hope my dad doesn't embarrass me while we're at the ministry. Sahi's father is also working at the ministry. Same department as Arthur Weasley. Regulation and control of Muggle artifacts? I don't remember. Oh, who cares? Charlie will be at the Ministry of Magic! Calm down, Tongs. You'll knock something over if you're not careful. Are you not excited, Sahi? Of course I am. I just don't know much about the Ministry of Magic. Okay, that's an absolute lie. You do. By the way, I've done the classes already, and if I've learnt anything from the Muggle studies, it's that MC is definitely a pure blood, canonically. Now, for me, Sarai is a half blood, so doesn't really care. I don't really care, but I'm just saying. I'm not really sure what to expect, to be honest. I do know I like to make a good first impression. If you're worried about that, I could tell you a bit about the ministry, Sarai. That would be brilliant, Charlie. We should meet in the courtyard to talk. No, you can literally just tell me right here. That way, I don't have to do an energy thing again. Gosh dang it, Charlie. The amount of things you have to do in the courtyard honestly baffles me. You have gobstones, you have the courtyard date, which I unlocked, by the way. Yes, I just couldn't make a video on it. Professor Flitwick agreed to give me some dueling tips. Good for you. Anyway, you've seen Fang's favorite stick. He's gone and lost it again. What is Fang actually doing? I heard that the first career expression assignments have been given out. Oh. Are they being given to specific students at one time? Hi Charlie, thanks for offering to tell me about the Ministry of Magic so I can make a good first impression. I think you should really be worried about how you dress if you want to make a good first impression, but I'll think about that later. Not a problem, Sarai. It's not as fun talking about dragons, but the Ministry is interesting and a good place to consider a future. You think so? I'm hoping that knowing more about departments will help me prepare for my first day. Sarai already knows this stuff, her father works there. End of story. Oh sure, there are a lot of different departments and some of them are quite strange. Strange? What do you mean strange? That seemed normal to me. Well, maybe not cursed world strange. What was that voice? It would probably be easier if I just told you about the different departments. Okay. Oh, criminal case, give me an analysis, is finished. Yeah, I knew this would happen. I knew at 3 a.m. in the morning I'd get a notification for this. There's how many departments are there in the Ministry of Magic? Too many to remember. I haven't read the books. I've only watched the movie and even those I have not paid good attention. Being Beast and Spirit are three divisions of the magical creature. What? Spirit is one of them? Good to see you, Sarai. Have you seen Fang's favorite stick? Yeah, I've been constantly throwing it at him so that, you know, he goes and chases it back to your hut. You know, the stick that we tap to get energy? I threw it and Fang went after it. And we played fetch and it was fun, you know? I don't know what I'm talking about. The Ministry of Magic has enchanted windows underground to mimic weather. Okay, that's really cool. Magical law enforcement where all the lawyers are employed? Okay. No, I want to work with Barnaby. I'm sorry. No, thank you. Go away. The accidental magic reversal squad helps reverse magical mishaps. You need an entire separate squad for that? Okay. just tell you, hope you make a good first impression. Think about how you dress first. This will probably be the last time Sarai is gonna have the ponytail. That is good news for some people, I guess. Some people have been yelling at me in the comments, why does Sarai have the ponytail? It doesn't look good. Look, there's an entire story behind that. And if I explain it now, we'd be here all day. But you would be happy to know that this is probably going to be the last time for now she's gonna have the ponytail. If I get the dress from the Full Marks, I really want the spring coat. And when she goes to the ministry, she'll have open hair, okay? So don't yell at me in the comments anymore. The Ministry of Magic sure does deal with a lot of different aspects of the wizarding world. Okay, this is why MC is stupid. MC is, okay, it's already been proven that MC is a pure blood. But it's like MC is not even a pure blood. Like, they don't know anything, honestly. It's like they were just born into existence and just thrown out in the world. To be honest, that is what they were, but it doesn't make any logical sense. Magical creature regulation, law enforcement, and magic reversal. Sounds like you could be just about anything working at the ministry. That's what my dad always says. Yeah, I guess Muggle governments don't do that. And he works in the misuse of Muggle artifacts office. Yes, that is where Sarai's father also works. It's a division of the Department of Magical Law Enforcement, separate from the Aurors. They regulate the use of magic on Muggle items and ensure Muggles don't own enchanted items. Do you think you'd ever want to work with your dad? Oh, I don't think I'm suited to work with my dad. I'd rather work in the Department for Regulation and Control of Magical Creatures. That's where I want to go! Of course, I should have known. You're more likely to see dragons that way. That's right, and if that didn't work out, I can always go to Romania and work at the Dragon Sanctuary. Even after that run-in with the Hungarian Horntail? Is that even a real question? Of course! Enough about me though. How do you feel now that you know more about the Ministry of Magic? I'm prepared. Oh, I'm completely prepared. I just want to go. I feel prepared more so than I was before our talk. Brilliant. You're going to do fantastic in the ministry, Sarai. Thanks. Thanks for taking time to talk to me, Charlie. You're my friend. It's the absolute least I can do. Besides, now you've got one less thing to worry about. Now you just need to figure out where you need to go, where you're going to get some flu powder. We know where to get flu powder. Wait. No, last time we used flu powder, Rakepeg gave it to us. That was in year 5, right? Maybe we want to get flu powder now. I suppose checking the flu network would be faster than the train. And since I was specifically chosen for this honor, maybe Snape will give me some flu powder? The only way to find out is to ask. I mean, don't all the students need flu powder? Isn't Dumbledore going to assign someone to provide us with actual flu powder? Better hurry up, Sarai. There's not much time left until our assignments at the ministry begin. You're right. I'll go see Snape right away to get some flu powder. Why Snape specifically? Why can't we ask literally anyone else? Okay, maybe Dumbledore told Snape to provide us with flu powder. Oh, hello. This man is still here. He looks a little weird, to be honest to me. Oh my god, here we go. All I am saying is that if you think about it, Muggle chemistry is really quite similar. It is. For the record, he's right. Oh, hello, Miss Tonks and Miss Silvers. Yes? Yes, that is correct, Professor Sikandar. I can't believe it. Okay, never mind. I'm not going to question the fact that he doesn't remember my name, okay? Tonks, I just wanted to ask Professor Snape about some flu powder, but I see you're busy. I am not. We were just having a friendly discussion about Muggle chemistry. Oh, all right. We could come back after your discussion. There is no discussion. Professor Sikandar is simply speaking. Well, what do you need flu powder for, Silvers? Did Dumbledore not tell you that he is sending us to the ministry for a flipping assignment? We need to go there. To go to the Ministry of Magic, Professor. We're going to learn what it takes to be Aurors. At least, I hope that's what we'll be learning about. Is that so? Yeah, did Dumbledore not tell you? Oh, Aurors, how lovely. You know, Muggles have got policemen. Yes, I know. And why would you be invited to the Ministry of Magic? Dumbledore told. I was invited because I'm just lucky, I suppose. Professor Dumbledore did specifically because to be assigned to the ministry for stuff. Speak clearly or not at all, Miss Tonks. Oh, I think that's a bit harsh, don't you? This man is the definition of harsh. Professor Sikandar, are you new here? Professor Sikandar, I wouldn't. Did I ask you for your opinion? Yes. Well, no. Then do not give it. Silvers, you will prove you understand how to use flu powder correctly before I give it to you. Alright, I'll tell you everything I know about flu powder right away. Rekpek told us, by the way. She didn't teach us well. I'll just come back to the point that Rekpek was literally one of the best teachers ever. Why is everything in this chapter 8 hours long? This is the third time. No, wait, those are the classes. The classes were 8 hours long, it's so is the thing. Flu powder is used to travel via the flu network, which connects the fireplaces. You must say your destination clearly to ensure we are literally repeating Rekpek. To ensure the arrival at the proper location. I know we are literally repeating exactly what Rekpek told us because I just actually was looking at Air 5 a couple of days ago. I don't know what screenshot I was looking for, but I was in that same chapter where Rekpek taught us about flu powder. So I know these are the exact lines. Blimey, I forgot how scary Snape is. How? How are you not used to this after 6 years? Are you often this way with your students, Professor Snape? Yes, this man is definitely new here. Oh, I see you've got the collection of books. Please just go read the books right now. Sir, you are very innocent and I feel bad about exposing you to Snape. Try to avoid knocking anything over, Miss Tonks. She's literally standing here with her hands behind her back for that reason exactly. She doesn't knock anything over. Oh, it's crap. I don't have all day, Silvers. You told me to tell you everything about flu powder. I'm doing that. I am telling you everything. You can use the flu network to travel to secure locations like the ministry. I don't remember if that was one of Rekpek's lines. There's little to no danger while using the flu network. Okay, that was Rekpek's line. Yes. Not the exact. The flu powder is used to travel via the flu network which connects. Oh my god. Oh, you guys know I just really enjoyed Rekpek. I really miss her. Really, I do. Oh my god. I know I'm going to get scolded for this opinion, but I really want Rekpek back. I think you guys knew that already. But the thing is, I hope Jam City doesn't bring her back, at least in the game, because I know they're just going to screw her over again. So, you know what? I'll just bring her back on my own, in my own story, and then I'll actually write her the way she was supposed to be written in the first place. To reinforce the most important things I know, the flu network uses a powder, speak loudly and clearly. And you can go to secure locations like the Ministry of Magic and Dumbledore's office is connected to the flu network. I think that's everything, Professor Snape. Oh? Well. Tell me, Silvers, why exactly one must speak loudly and clearly even using the flu network? To arrive at the proper location. I'm not stupid. You must speak loudly and clearly so that you arrive at the proper location. Not like Harry Potter, where you were supposed to go to a Diagon Alley and he's just diagonally. That's correct. It seems your last brain cell. I've seen companies share one brain cell and it's constantly being put through rigorous use. And actually, most of the time, it's not being used at all. That's why MC asks stupid questions like, oh, the last vault must be in the Black Lake. Yes, you knew that since you found the trident. You've known that for a year. Why are you still asking me that question? Okay, why am I talking about this now? So that vault is like done for. But you seem to know enough. I will give you and Mr. Holmes this flu powder on the condition that you do not engage in any tomfoolery. We literally just want to go to the ministry. How is that talk? Never mind. I don't know if I can promise that. No, Holmes! We can do that, Professor Snape. We literally just have to go to the ministry. I don't know what tomfoolery we can actually engage in with flu powder. Very well. This will be enough to get you to and from the ministry. Brilliant! I suppose I'll have to start scouting a fireplace we can use. You can just use the one in... Hopefully somewhere... You idiot! You absolute idiot! Okay. Hopefully somewhere nearby. You can just... All three of you need to leave immediately. Oh, do you have another class coming in? No, I simply cannot stand any of you. Oh, I see. This man is just realizing all of this. Why do you look so disappointed? First of all, I'm not even looking at Cory. Cory, what are you doing here? Whoa. I've got news about, you know, our thing. All of you out! Looks like you'll have to tell me on the way, Cory. Sure, let's go to the Great Hall. Do these people not understand what privacy is? Great hall, really? And MC is stupid. Do you not remember about the fireplace in Dumbledore's office that you used to get to Nocturne Alley? Yes, I did not do the list side quest, but that's because the 70 is a roadblock. I need to be at 71. Otherwise, I'm getting, what do you call it? I'm just getting setbacks, okay? Oh, hi, Ben. Oh, hi. I'm all prepared to go to the ministry. Yes, I can see that you have a sweater on. Barnaby, put some casuals on, please. Beatrice! Oh my god, I missed you. Should I wear my lucky socks? I should. Or is that too silly? What if they're too lucky? Dude, please wear your lucky socks. Please wear something casual. Chamshetty, give him casuals. Oh my god, please. Please don't send him to the ministry in uniform. I don't want that. I'm so excited to go to the ministry. How are they up to they're up to regulation on teacher handling? I mean, they're the ministry. They should be, right? Also, Beatrice! Beatrice! Oh my god, it's been a while. Oh no. Oh, Beatrice just have to witness something this traumatizing again. Sarahi, you will be pleased to know I have found us a star witness. Beatrice? Yeah, hi. Give me a hug. Give me a hug, sweetheart. I missed you. Can we make this quick? I've got things to do. Sure, of course. I want to hug her. Sure, of course. Corey? Whoa. Well, don't hold back, Sarahi. Tell Sarahi what you told me. You are far too excited. Don't mind him, Beatrice. Just tell me whatever it is you know. If I must. What do you mean if you must? It's got to do with Marula. Okay, now Beatrice is one of these people who know about Marula, but what about her? Oh, just wait until you hear. Dude, shut up. Will you two stop interrupting me? I'm sorry. Sorry, Beatrice. Please continue. As I was saying before you so rudely, it was him. It is about Marula. Belt up and listen to me. You'll want to know everything I have to say. I'm listening. Please tell me. And you're only talking to me for an hour. I love you, Beatrice. I've always loved Beatrice. You guys know that. And I'm just... I'm not sure what Marula's been doing at the Whomping Willow, but it's weird. Oh my god. It's not... Beatrice shouldn't be the one to have to witness this. She's a child. She's already traumatized enough. Please stop. I mean, I love Beatrice, but this is just like the detective has a conversation per month. Corey, for the love of God, stop being so excited. I'm trying to listen to Beatrice here. On my box, I've seen Marula hanging about the Whomping Willow. Okay. Marula's always in a foul mood after coming back from the Whomping Willow. Why? Why is she in a foul mood? Anything you share would be useful, Beatrice. What is Marula up to now? Sorry, I'm just so excited. Dude, shut up for 5 seconds. I love you, but please. Where did everyone go? Okay. I hope there's going to be vegan options for lunch at the ministry if we get lunch. I think we'll have to bring our own lunch. What's the matter with you? There's just far too many socks options for me to wear. Wear your lucky socks. Seriously, you'll need it. Lucky socks are good socks. I'm not sure what Marula's been... Yeah, okay, I get it. Sarahi being so excited to see Marula... Beatrice, that she literally give Beatrice a hug. Believe me, I would. So Marula's been going back home to the Whomping Willow. And always comes back in a bad mood. That's what I just said, yes. Sorry, Beatrice, I'm just thinking out loud. Yeah, whatever, I'm going to go now. Are you okay? Bye, Beatrice, thank you for helping. So, what do you think of Marula going to the Whomping Willow? It says suspicious considering we found the R note there. I think it's suspicious. Who would just go to the Whomping Willow by themselves? That's what I was thinking. It's totally suspicious. Please calm down. That reminds me. The Whomping Willow was a known communications depot for R. In that case, you should definitely, at the very least, take a look. I agree. We should definitely investigate. Are you up to coming to the Whomping Willow with me? That's what detective commission or a persons would do, right? Whoa. It is. But you've got to leave for the Ministry of Magic soon. Blindly, you're right. I'll keep an eye on Marula while you're gone. We've got to know for sure if she's the mole before we expose her. Whoa. What? Oh my god, every chapter in this thing makes me angry. We know Marula is the mole. I don't even care that my camera is shaking. We watched it happen. Why isn't this being addressed that we watched it. We saw. Even the best detective teams have to divide and conquer sometimes. Okay. Thank you so much, Corey. Hi, Donks. What's your Sarahi, Corey? Hope you don't mind if I steal Sarahi for a bit, Corey. We've got a ministry to get to. Not a problem, Donks. You two will have a smashing time in the ministry. I sure hope so. Come on then. I found the perfect fireplace to use to flew to the ministry. Fantastic, Donks. The only thing is, it's an auxiliary and you'll have to convince the owner. Madam Rosemurta. Why don't we just use the one in Dumbledore's office? Oh my god. The stupidity here is baffling me. No time to waste then. Next stop, Hogsmeade, and then the Ministry of Magic. I need to change. I mean, I don't have the full marks thing yet. Oh, come on. Did you really just... How does one misplace flu powder? Also, really, the three broomsticks? Dude, I'm not saying it's not a good option, but you already knew Dumbledore's office had a flu... had a fireplace connected to the flu network. You used it in Year 5. Has Jamsetti forgotten about Year 5? Now it's like they're only giving references to Year 6, not Year 5. Or maybe the lesson about flu powder was a reference, I don't know. But seriously, we already know about the one in Dumbledore's office. Why is MC stupid? Why is this game stupid? Can't talk, working on some new designs. Good, I need a dress before getting to the ministry. I imagine Andre just being like, is that what you're wearing to the ministry? And just shoving that spring peacoat to Sarahi. Like, you must wear something with flowers. Flowers are aesthetic, Sarahi. Will you let me play with jokes this time, Rosmata? No. She's gonna... I think I see why she's mad at him. Nothing suspicious going on here. I can see you're making a dodgy deal. But you know what? I will not interrupt. And why is this girl always around? Is she the mole? I swear to God, this girl is always around. I'm wearing my favorite shirt. Okay, you're not mad anymore, thank goodness. Hi, Madam Rosmata. Tongues and I were wondering if... Are you still mad? If we could use your fireplace to flew to the Ministry of Magic, I'm hoping to learn about being an Auror. Calm down, Tongs. Starting in the magical law enforcement doesn't necessarily mean going to the Auror office. Oh, how delightful. I'm so proud of you too. Oh, good, she's not mad at us this time. Thank you, Madam Rosmata. So, can we use your fireplace? Make sure to watch your step. Keep your arms at your sides. Speak loudly and clearly. And most importantly, don't track in any ashes. I don't want to be cleaning up after another mess. Of course, Madam Rosmata. We'll be careful, I promise. Tongs, that goes doubly for you. I promise I'll try not to make another ashy mess. Or any other kind of mess. Well, alright. Good luck at the ministry. I'm sure you'll be just brilliant. Well, the only thing left to do now is just throw the flu powder and go, yeah? What are you doing? Oh! I can't believe you're about to go explore the Ministry of Magic. We're not going to get to the ministry until chapter 5. So, this is probably the last part. And I'm pretty sure, like, logically, Sarahi should have changed before coming to the three broomsticks. So I'm pretty sure, like, in my canon, they won't be going yet. Andre will stop. So I say, is that what you're wearing? Have her changed and then she'll go. Feels like the first real step in actually getting to choosing a visiting career. I cannot read. All we got to do is throw in the flu powder and go. Oh, what's the rush? I mean, we could just sit and have a butterbeer first. I mean, we could. Tongs, are you okay? A second ago, you couldn't wait to go to the Ministry of Magic. Now you're nervous? Sarahi, what if I turn out to be a rotten aura? You'll be fine. There, you'll be fine. You'll be an excellent aura, Tongs. There's no doubt about that. I feel all jittery. And not like when I eat a bunch of candy, but like when Snape yells at me. How are you still not used to being yelled at by Snape after all these years? I understand. Going outside of Hogwarts is a really big deal and we should both want to make a good impression. And I know you'll make a fantastic first impression. Thanks, but do you need a pep talk? You know what? That might actually help. Good, because I'm interested, because I'm excited. I'll be happy to give you a pep talk this one time. But then listen carefully. I knew we wouldn't be going anywhere without doing something involving energy. So, well, why not just give Tongs a pep talk? She needs it, and I'll be happy to give it this time. Andre be like, is that what you're wearing? It's so dull. Please wear something brighter. Wear something with flowers, Sarahi. Flowers are your aesthetic. Flowers are Sarahi's aesthetic. So, yeah. Leave it yourself and you can do just about anything you set your mind to. Okay, that's so cliche, honestly. If you're gonna get dogs and pep talk, at least don't make it cliche, please. What if I mess up or knock something over? That's just tongs being tongs, honestly. Sometimes you gotta work a little harder than for our dreams than we expected. I wish that wasn't true, honestly. I can't remember the last time someone gave me a pep talk. Oh boy, please don't devolve to angst. Quit eavesdropping on me, it's bad for business. Sorry! I'm sorry. You're amazing, Miss Tonks. Never forget that. Yeah, I do love Tonks. Good luck, you two. Thank you, Madam Rosmata. You wanted to be in all of us as long as you have known you. Don't give up now. Yeah, be excited. Be Tonks. Did I close the shop? Yes. No. Maybe. How do you come into another place and forget to close your shop? Come on. And also, this is done. I'm done with dialogue already. Actually, here's how I think it's going to be. They're like just about to throw in the flu powder. Andre is like, stop! Is that what you're wearing? No, I'm giving you this dress right now. Go change. And so he's like, why do I need to change? You know what? You're right, Sahi. I am an amazing witch and I'm determined to be an aura. Yeah, good. That's the tongs I know. Nothing will stop me when I have this much willpower. Yay! There's the tongs I know. Thank you, Sahi, for everything. I love you. I love Tonks. Of course, you're my friend. You're the friend who's going to be absolutely brilliant at the Ministry of Magic. Your friend who's going to be absolutely brilliant at the Ministry of Magic. Then let's stop talking and get going. I don't want to be late on my first day. Ministry of Magic! I hope she made it there, okay? Well, I best be off myself. Now, logically, Sahi would have already changed at this point. Oh, is he gonna stop me? What do you want now? Not so fast, Sahi. What happened? Madai, what are you doing here? And how did he know I was going to be here? No time for your questions. You're headed to the Ministry of Magic, right? Yes. I am. Don't worry about Murula. I made a new friend and he's gonna keep an eye on her. That's good to hear, Sahi. Okay, and? Unfortunately, I'm not here to celebrate. I've got a warning for you. What? Has something happened? Is Jacob okay? Jacob is fine. It's you who needs to worry. Okay, thank God. Jacob is fine. It's no coincidence that your first assignment is at the Ministry. I believe R has agents inside the Ministry. I knew it. I knew it. I always knew that. That is why in my head, Canon Rick is already broken out. Just tell me what you need me to do and I'll do it, Mr. Moody. And honestly, you don't need to tell me. I'll be careful. Need you to keep an eye out for anything suspicious. This time you won't be on your own though. I've got contacts at the Ministry helping me. Who are they? I'll make sure to get into contact with them. Okay, there's this mosquito running around. I don't know if it's gone actually. It's just not on my keyboard anymore. Can't say too many years here. Just be careful with who you trust when you get to the Ministry. You know, it would be a lot easier if you just told me. Of course, Madai, constant vigilance. Indeed. Now, off you go to the Ministry for your first assignment. Okay. Hey, don't have to push me. Ministry of Magic. We won't get there in this chapter.
You make the hardest task look easy.
Sir, you didn't have to push me. That's rude. Also, yes, chapter's over. I think I will have the spring P code by the time we're done. We get to the next chapter. So, I'm really just not worried. I'll have that outfit. I'm gonna win that full marks if it's the last thing I do. Okay, so this chapter wasn't very interesting, to be honest, to me. But, yeah, well, we're going to the Ministry of Magic. I still find it extremely stupid that we took the one at Three Broomsticks. It would have been more logical to take the one at Dumbledore's office. It's literally Dumbledore assigned us this. We already knew about the one at the Ministry, I can't speak anymore. We already knew about the fireplace at Dumbledore's office. I don't know why we didn't use it. Default NC is just extremely stupid. But other than that, we're done with this chapter and I would like to get this done before the music stops because I had like tons of homework to do today. Oh my God. Yeah, when I got back yesterday from college, I was extremely exhausted. We had a party a couple of days ago. It was awesome. I had fun. It was the first time I'd been to a party in years. It's like my body is having an allergic reaction to a party. My back hurts, my foot hurts, and my head hurts. Everything hurts. And I don't like it because I actually had fun and I don't want my body having an allergic reaction. I don't know why I'm having allergic reactions. But anyway, I'm not going to rant about that. This is me like thinking for 5 minutes before I actually give a good outro line. You guys have no idea how much stuff I have to cut out. Okay, one more thing. On Tuesday, I was going to record the Liz side quest. I was going to. But because her attributes are always needed one level higher, it's a roadblock because I keep getting... diamonds keep getting taken away from me. And I'm not going to keep wasting coins on that. I'm just going to wait till I get to level 71. And then I'll do the Liz side quest. I'm not in a hurry, really. I mean, I'm sure you guys have already seen it or played it at this point. And the music has stopped. Ultimately, I can't do anything before the music stops, right? Please put music in editing to not make this awkward. So, I couldn't record the Liz side quest on Tuesday after I got back. So, I decided since everything was set up, I would record Friday Night Funkin'. It's an awesome game. I'd had it on my computer for a week and I just really wanted to play it for the first time, but for a video. I recorded for a full hour. And when I was done recording and I was just about to begin transferring videos to, edit, I realized that the game didn't record at all. I don't know why the Xbox game bar only works with BlueStacks and doesn't work with anything else. So I've used the OBS and even OBS did not work for I don't know what reason. So I played the entirety of Friday Night Funkin' weeks 1 to 6 whole. So some of them on normal mode, some of them on baby mode because I was bad. And well, it didn't record. So that would have been a great video. I'm really sad it didn't record. I'm debating eventually live streaming Friday Night Funkin' when I get a second monitor and an actual microphone. Until then, I'll just have to stick with this one video a week. I really want to play Friday Night Funkin', okay? I've also like looked up how to mod it. I want to try and mod Sarahi into Friday Night Funkin'. Maybe I can even replace the lady with I think that is week 3 or week 4, maybe, I don't remember. The mommy who must, do the thing that must not be named. Who has the 3 songs. I don't know if you guys know, but one of those female characters. I'm thinking I should mod Rakepig there. I want to see if I can mod Rowan to replace the girlfriend. And I want to see if I can redraw Sarahi into that art style so that I can put her in the place of the boyfriend. I also want to make a Barnaby sprite and like things. I don't know. I'm just excited. Okay. I want to try and mod this game. It'll probably take me a lot of effort and a couple of months because I'm slow as freak. But I'm gonna try. I really do want to try. It's an easy game to mod, so I want to try. I can't mod the songs. I don't understand how to mod the songs yet. I only don't understand how to mod the sprites. But I don't know why I have said this idea. Now I'll be obligated to do it. Anyway, the today's chapter is over. Eh? And in the next chapter, we'll be looking at the Ministry of Magic and that will be fun. And with that note, I shall leave you guys to enjoy your own chapter. And I've just been rambling on for 5 minutes about things that nobody cares about. So on that note, before I start rambling on any further, I will say bye bye guys and have a nice day. Enjoy your chapter.